Hi gang, does cold water boil faster than hot water? The answer is no, but why might a lot of people think it does? In this short science video, I'll show some rigorous science experiments I did that give some clues into all this. The usual way this experiment is done is to time how long a pot of cold water takes to boil, and then how long a pot of hot water takes to boil. But I wanted to go deeper. I wanted to see how fast the temperature changes when the water is cold, how fast it changes when it's warm, and how fast it changes when it's hot. From known physics, I already suspected there would be a difference, so I set up an experiment to test it. I started with the usual pot and the usual cooking thermometer. The problem there is that most of the cooking thermometer isn't even in the water. When I did this, I found the water was actually boiling while the thermometer was saying it was only around 70 degrees Celsius or 160 Fahrenheit. The boiling temperature of water is 100 Celsius or 212 Fahrenheit. The part of the thermometer in the air was making the thermometer cooler than the water and not telling me what I needed to know. So I got one of these. It's an automobile coolant temperature sensor. But underneath the protective metal case, it's a thermistor. Of course, I made some additions to make it useful for my purposes. I also made a holder for the thermistor that I could use to sit it in the bottom of my pot. It's made of clothes hanger wire, and it's adjustable as needed by bending the wire. Notice that when it's in the pot with water, the majority of the sensor is actually in the water, which is what I was after. One way to use it is to connect it to a meter that's set to measure resistance. As the temperature here increases, the resistance on the meter decreases. If you know what resistance equates to what temperature, then you can monitor the temperature that way, by taking resistance measurements. In another video, I show how to figure out the resistance-temperature relationship, since I couldn't find that information anywhere for this one. More about that at the end. Now for the experiment. First, I want to test starting with cold water. I put 250 milliliters, or 1 cup of water, in the freezer with my thermistor in it, such that the bottom part was in the water. When the resistance was above 528 ohms, which according to my table is 6 Celsius, or 43 Fahrenheit, I took it out. I put the thermistor in the bottom of the pot, and connected the meter to the thermistor. With the stove element nice and hot, I poured the water into the pot. I put the pot on the stove element, started the timer, and started recording resistance values from the meter every 10 seconds. Once I reached 31 ohms on the thermistor, which is around boiling, I stopped recording. Next, I repeated the experiment using the hottest water I can get from the hot water tap. Here are the results for the cold water test. And here are the results for the hot water test. And overlapping them, we get this. Horizontally across the bottom we have time, and vertically on the sides is temperature. So the cold water started at 15 Celsius, or 59 Fahrenheit, and it ended at 96 Celsius, or 205 Fahrenheit, the hottest I measured before stopping. The cold water took 3 minutes to boil. The hot water took 1 minute and 50 seconds to boil. So the answer to the first question is that hot water does boil sooner than cold water, or faster, as it's often stated. But what about the second question? Why is there this idea that cold water might boil faster? Look carefully at the chart. Notice that the data forms curves, not straight lines. The heating is faster during this part where the water is still cool. Then the heating slows down when the water is warm, and then it really slows down when the water is hot. This is actually known science. The greater the temperature difference you have between the hot side and the cold side, the faster the heat is transferred. And the closer the two temperatures are, the slower the heat is transferred. And that's likely where the misconception comes from. When the water is cold, the heat is transferred faster, but only when it's cold. Once it reaches the same temperature as the water that was started at a hotter temperature, the heat is transferred at the same rate as for that hot water. From then on, they follow the same curve. The rate of heating for the cold water has cut up to the rate of heating for the hot water, and from then on, they take the same amount of time. Well, thanks for watching. See my YouTube channel, rimstar.org, for more fun science videos like this. That includes the one I mentioned talking about how I adapted the automobile coolant temperature sensor, or thermistor, and made the necessary resistance to temperature measurements table, one on how to make a steam vacuum and how it works, and one explaining what fire is. And don't forget to subscribe if you like these videos, or give a thumbs up, or leave a question or comment below. See you soon!